Scorpio, thanks for viewing my general tarot for December 2018. Remember, these readings are based on collective energies for zodiac signs. That means don't take it as your life. Use the resonating messages as a tool to shed light on issues that need your attention. Now, you can get a reading where you can ask personal questions and get personalized advice. That's my suggestion. Thanks for liking my videos and subscribing. I just wanted to say that. Feel free to leave comments. My donation, Instant Go, and Vimeo information are in the description. Now let's get it for Scorpio, December 2018. I've already shuffled for the most part. Oh yeah, I'm gonna pull from the Sacred Rebels Oracle deck first before we start. What is already with you, and I'm also going to pull one from the Chakra Insight Oracle really fast as I can go. And that one is self-expression. That's a okay. I don't know. I have to look in the book. But one of the cards is number 17, What is Already With You. That's from Sacred Rebels. And the other card is from Chakra Insight Self-Expression. That's the Seven of Wands. I'm using the Greenwood Tarot. I usually use this deck for clarifying, but I'm going to replace it. I really like this, the way it handles. I don't drop these as much. Seven of Wands, Queen of Cups in reverse. Okay. Nine of Swords. Eight of Pentacles. With the Seven of Wands, let's see. This is the Seven of Wands in this deck. It looks like she is collecting wands or she's cleaning house. Queen of Cups in reverse. Seven of Wands. Mm-hmm. Seven of Wands can indicate a Leo. Nine of Swords can indicate a Gemini. Queen of Cups can indicate a Gemini or a Cancer. Eight of Pentacles would be a Virgo. All signs, so she's cleaning house. We got the Queen of Cups in reverse here. That means she could be she could be neglectful. She could be mean. The Nine of Swords. And this person is probably mean. The Queen of Cups could be a Gemini or a Cancer, and she's suffering emotionally and she's suffering mentally. Like, something is wearing, is digging deep into her. The Suit of Swords is on either side of her, and she's in reverse. So that means suits, she is suffering, and swords represent mental clarity or lack thereof. So it's not a good feeling. It's not a good feeling. Coming out of that into the Eight of Pentacles. This guy right here. He's working. He's got some pentacles built up, but he's not even looking at that. He's not even paying attention to that. He's just putting the work in. And he's also through the King of Wands, he's also a Virgo. King of Wands, he's in reverse. Knight of Cups, reverse. High Priestess, reverse. Okay, let's clarify. I'm just going to clarify each card. Okay. Seven of Wands, clarified by the Wheel of the Year, which is the Wheel number 10, the Wheel of Fortune. Clarify the Queen of Cups in reverse. She's clarified by the Ten of Earth. Nine of Swords, clarified by the Nine of Water. Wow, two nines right there, y'all. Eight of Pentacles, clarified by the Empress. The High Priestess in this deck. Clarify the King of Wands in reverse. Clarify by the Seven of Air. Knight of Chalices in reverse. Clarify by this is the Justice card in the Book of Shadows. This is the Book of Shadows tarot. So that's the Justice card, and it's in reverse, clarifying the Knight of Cups. Clarify the High Priestess in reverse. High Priestess clarified by the Clone of Fire. Okay. So, the Queen of Cups and this is Scorpio's reading. I want to okay, first of all, this queen is in the reverse, and I'm about to clarify her again. She's already clarified by the Ten of Earth, or the Ten of Pentacles, and it's in reverse. Ten of Earth in reverse. So we got the Queen of Cups, the Ten of Pentacles in reverse. She's just going through it, like, right now. Damn. Damn. Alright. So the Queen of Chalices in reverse here is, she's going through it. Like, I've heard people say the dark night of the soul and all that. I don't know what, you know, like, I don't know to say that that's what this is. It looks like this is where she knows she's supposed to be here. Right, she's supposed to be at the finish line to the winning prize, right, to the grand prize. This is the Wheel of Fortune, and that's where she's supposed to be. She has to get there, right? She's gonna get there, but right now she has to accept these swords. She has nine swords, right? And they're just keeping her up at night. Like, all these swords, she has these swords, and she's using them against herself, right? She needs to pack them up and use them, you know, for her own good. But she's clarified by the Seven of Pentacles, the Eight of Wands, Seven of Pentacles in reverse, Seven of Wands, Eight of Wands, Nine of Swords, Ten of Swords, and the Wheel. And with all that, she's trying to get from here she's trying to get from here to here. That's the best way I can put it, because it looks like so we'll say that she came from here. She came from here, and she is going hold on. Let me look at this again. Oh my God. Okay, I just heard the word. Sacrifice, right? So, something here is being what is she giving up? Let's clarify. Well, we got Pentacles and Wands in reverse. So it looks like the Queen of Swords is letting something, or the Queen of Cups is letting something go. So a Gemini or Cancer, it could be any sign, but the Queen of Cups is in reverse, and she's a Gemini or a Cancer. And she's got a lot of fire in her clarification, so, you know, there could be some fire energy involved, or earth energy, but she is giving something up. It looks like she's given up the Wheel, the luxuries, the Pentacles, and I'll show you why I say, because, you know, this was her, this was her 10, this was her Wheel of Fortune, and this is, she comes up as Queen in reverse and Ten of Pentacles in reverse. She's clarified there by Seven of Pentacles in reverse, Eight of Wands in reverse, Six of Swords in the upright. So she's, her mind is made up. She's sacrificed. She's put things on the line that she held dear. And she's journeying into, I'm just going to call it no man's land, because, like, this is, like, mental anguish. Like, this is like being stuck in your own head, right? And it was upright. It was in the upright. So yeah, she's She gave up luxury. She gave up pinnacles. She gave up whatever her passion was. And she's moving towards possibly a job. Possibly, you know, it's possible that this could be love. But this two card, the High Priestess, is clarifying the Eight of Pentacles that she's going for. Wow. Okay, so what that looks like is saying to me is that she's changing, right? She's changing. She left the life that she knew, and she's leaving for, she has to go through all the growing pains of leaving where you were comfortable. And she's got to put the work in, right? She's got to put the work in. That's what the Eight of Pentacles is. And maybe, you know, there may be some family involved here, some family that she's doing this for. Some relationship, maybe not sexual or romantic, but some relationship that she's committed to saving or helping someone. She's probably doing this to help someone. But the Eight of Pentacles is clarified by the wisdom card in the Book of Shadows Tarot. And that's the High Priestess. She's in the upright. And it looks like she is laying down the crown. Because now she has to journey through the dark side. Like, let me clarify and quit making that. Please help me to read what the cards are saying. Please help me to read the cards. Why is the High Priestess here? Okay. That's what I like. Oh my goodness. So we have the seven, the eight, the nine, the wand. Before she gets to the High Priestess in the spread. So she's moving. Let me figure this out. Okay, so we got the Okay, so she's got the 8 and the 7. The 7 and the 8 of Pentacles. So she grows in that direction. The 8 of Wands, 9 of Wands. 7, 8, 9. All right. Okay. So okay. This is going to be long. Okay, so if she is afraid, why is the 9 of Wands? Can't get the question out. Okay, so oh my God, y'all, look, I couldn't even get the question out. Let's see, the Knight of Wands in reverse, Page of Wands, 5 of Wands. I'm just getting more and more scared, right? Like, I'm getting more and more scared. This is a spiritual battle. Page of Wands. It's a spiritual battle. And then we got the High Priestess here. Okay. So let me hurry up and do this. Okay. So we've got the High Priestess and then eventually, she's clarified by the Ace of Cups. Hold on. Then, come back to the Seven of Swords. Hold on. Page of Pentacles fell out on top of the Ace of Cups. Hold on. King of Wands. Okay, so whatever the Queen of Cups has to go through. It's a spiritual battle. It doesn't matter that she was born or comfortable in a life of physical luxury, right? This Wheel of Fortune says that she has to roll on. Rolling. I can't do Tina Turner. Sunshine Tarot can do the hell out of Tina Turner. But she has to roll into new territory now. Can't live off of what you build. You have to grow. So that's where the anguish, right? Just a little bit. There you go. Okay. So that's where the anguish. And like, if Wands, and I clarified the 9 of Wands, right? To me, this was being defensive, right? But in the reverse, for me, it was being defensive, but the other end of defensive, like where you scramming to hide yourself, not so much, you know, trying to defend yourself, but trying to hide yourself. So I took that as fear. And it was all clarified by the Page of Wands, the Knight of Wands, the Five of Wands. And I'm going by what's on the cards now, like what comes out on the deck that I'm looking at. That's a dragon. I'ma call it a demon. But this, because whatever my question was, why is this card in reverse? And what is the fear? Why the fear? So there are some people, the Knight and the Page of Wands, the Knight of Wands can be a Sagittarius or a Scorpio, or this could relate to the date that indicates Scorpio on the, Scorpio or Sag. So this could relate to anywhere between October 24th and December 21st, right? That's what these can indicate, these two cards here. And they're in reverse. So they can be the Knight of Wands, that can be Scorpio, between November 12th and November 22nd, okay. And the Page of Wands can be a Cancer or a Leo between July 12th and August 11th. Those are the dates for, them on the astrology wheel. So, we also have the Page of Pentacles that came out. She's in the upright. So, we can look at this two different ways. You can be going into this possibly, the dark night of the soul in fear, You could be going into this questioning yourself. But that's how it is at the beginning of most new starts. It looks like there's work to do. It looks like there's work to do. Okay, there you go. It looks like there's a lot of work to do. But you emerge victorious. I think it's important to remember that everything you needed, you had in the beginning, right? Apply this to whatever situation you're going through, Scorpio. But whatever you need now, you've always had. It wasn't material. It is what was always with you. This card that came out at first before we started spreading stuff out is number 17. It is what is already with you. So there's another half of this story. I think I'm going to put it in a separate video. But like this card, like this whole story is just reminding me of that song by Kelly Clarkson, when she be like, da 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 da. Da 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 da. What is the name of that song? Blue. Hello? Okay. So the name of the song is far away or go away, fly away, or something like that. But yeah, this is what the cards are describing. That's crazy. We pulled this card first, but this is what they're describing. Letting go, right? And remembering that you don't really have to be afraid, you know, of this new journey. But going forward, it does look like there's the King of Wands in reverse. He's clarified by the Seven of Swords in the upright. The Knight of Cups in reverse, clarified by Justice in reverse. Okay, let's clarify. Wait, not these yet. This. The Knight of Cups could be an Aquarius or a Pisces. Knight of Wands, again, he's a Scorpio or a Sag. Let's clarify the Crown of Fire, which is the King of Wands. He's clarified by the Knight of Pentacles. Oh my. Okay. So So we got the King of Cups clarifying the King of Wands, they're both in reverse. Okay. So I'm going to review this next portion of this spread in the part two for this video. So I'm going to go ahead and shut it down here. Thanks for hanging out. There's going to be a part two where we'll finish up with this end of the journey.